just standing up on the woman.
Greetings, annoying intro tolerators. This time, I'm playing chess. I think this is chess. Jesus Christ on a stick. Where's this room? Also, I think I've got the key in my inventory that I took. Yes, I do. See, it's the library key. You see, it's the key to the library. Well, you can go get some muffins and stick them on your head. Maybe put some traffic lights and go da 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 da, directing cars around the planet because teaching kids about pollution through way of some sort of crazy 90s program. Or multiple ones at the same time being beamed directly into your brain. What am I zip-zapping about? No one's ever going to know. I'm clearly going the wrong way to the library. I just made that judgment now without any proof whatsoever. Oh boy, what is on the wall? To all guards, if you think I do not notice that some of you are constantly leaving your posts in order to hold a dart tournament and having a neat booze in the rear guard corridor, then you deceive yourselves considerably. If you please to do so in your free time, then I don't care, provided you show up in a reasonably sober state as soon as your shift starts. However, should I catch one of you leaving his post on duty, I will personally drag him to Lord Borlimus. That is a synonym for Satan. John Berger, Captain of the Guard. I know he doesn't talk like normal, but since when am I consistent? None of the time, okay? No external, no internal, no map, no tizens. All right, no teasing the burricks there. Don't get hungry and bite your nose off. All right, actually.
Oh, show yourself.
Oh, that's a pretty good request there, sir. So I'm not going to grant it because I'm a bad guy. Yeah, I'm a bad guy. Look at all this equipment in an armory. I can't believe it could happen. Well, I'm even going to leave you and find a different way in here because I'm so incroyable. And by different way, I guess I mean like right friggin' here or not. Because what? What is that crazy insane room over there if the stairs won't care? Blah, 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 blah. Oh, hey, you. Maybe you will inform me. This is like such a good place for a thief, just silhouette in the doorway, while a dude just walks toward me. Oh yeah, not even gonna go in that room. Just gonna go over here. Tolerate the amazing stench in this manor, cause it smells of red. Ish, and so forth. Still not here. Still, well, maybe that room is like the ultra armory, and I should just do what I always do. But you know, the one time I try not to just knock everybody out is the one time I'm punished for doing so. Dear Lord Borlimus, as per your request, my men have been observing that minstrel Bill for the past 3 weeks. Unfortunately, I fear that their findings will give you no joy. Your daughter, Lady Corinna, has met several times with this individual outside the property. Affections have been exchanged on these occasions. I'm really sorry to inform you about this. Furthermore, this minstrel is a permanent guest at that disreputable tavern named Old Tokyo Inn. Apparently, he earns his meager livelihood by playing music in this pub along with his friends, if that caterwaul can be considered music at all. Also, it should be mentioned that Bill seems to have established a friendly relationship with David, one of your servants. My men observed several meetings between the two in the Old Tokyo Inn. Please let me know if the observation of this minstrel should be continued, and whether or not my men are supposed to intervene in case of future meetings between Bill and Lady Corinna. John Berger, make your daughters do a thing they don't want, Captain of the Guard, and also of said act.
Alright, well, that's extremely interesting room. Also, there's something on top of here. What could it be? His lordship's favorite pipe.
And you exist. Like, what are you doing?
What's that?
Oh, you're just a normal person. Uh-oh. But you've got a key.
The air is getting so filthy lately.
Borlimus's key. Why would I want to do? Well, this is a situation and no mistake. Yeah. I tried my absolute hardest. I did. But like, I didn't know a guard came in here. That's ridiculous. Stop that.
That's bad news for Britain.
Yes?
Don't make that noise.
Anyone there?
I thought I heard something.
He's right here!
Hey, stop!
What is going on? Oh, wait, there's this too. Okay.
Hello?
Fine. Oh, fine-ish. Jeez. Okay, that's perfectly fine, but oh, lady, I want your key. Lady. Lady. I want your key. You don't see nothing! What is wrong with you? What is going on over there? Seriously. I guess I'll have to get your key later. Yeah, this is a fine situation. Well, the Rebe wasn't clear on whether this was tested or not. I mean, it seems to work okay-ish, except for that silliness, but, you know, it was found on one of her backup CDs, so, like, who knows the quality of this baked good. Baked bad! No, this mission isn't bad. That was just a reference. Right, you.
Taking a break.
Is this the kind of can't even see you knock an arrow with your back turn kind of syndrome? Because you should... Shut up! These guys literally see, like, nothing at all, nothing. Like, what? Oh, well. That is wrong. That is wrong. And should be jailed forthwith. God, it's like not what it's supposed to do. I'm getting so angry about this because that's what I do. It's amazing. It's because I'm a nerd and I get angry about worthy things. Such as using the wrong voice when saying that it is okay for you to date my daughter. Making decisions for my daughter will cause her to grow up to be mentally healthy and capable of teaching her own children any kind of thing whatsoever. This was sarcasm. Thank you. And yes, there's that voice again. Just in case you were wondering where it went, well, it got stuffed back into my pocket, but it is now out and about. Or oot and a boot.
Someone there?
What? Hey, lady.
I don't have any mother.
How's it going? You know what? I'm gonna steal your key properly, okay? I'm gonna steal your key like a gent. Like quite a gent, even. Did I get? Yes. Okay, so most precious wine and favorite pipe. Now, maybe the wine is in the wine cellar, because it'd be silly if it was just in the same old darn old place. I guess it would be silly, and if there's anyone who recognizes something silly when I see it, it's me! Except, of course, the times when I don't get jokes. Oh, wow. Such as the one about bold and italic, which I just didn't hear, but I didn't want to say I didn't hear it, because that would be wooed, so instead I just claim not to get it, which is even stupider sounding, so I... So,
what's that?
I guess for some reason he has a key. That's his office. This must be his bedroom key, I suppose, where we can find all sorts of heavy metal punk rockers attempting to bed people. Because bedding people, that looks like it could be valuable. But... Hey, looks are deceiving is a thing I just decided. And yeah, I'm gonna have to go back to that armory. You've got very bad vision. Much worse than what I've got. La da 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 do da do. Okay, let's try to find the armory. Libertine men and horrible liberals, and that may or may not mean the same thing. What do I know? Probably more than I'm letting on. Ho 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 ho, the plot is revealed, probably. I should probably stop closing doors behind me like a smart person. Unfortunately. What did I saw and or heard something? See, I looked up.
Was greatly rewarded with a ladder. Oh, man. Just love ladders. Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, looks like this is
the wall. Of course it's the wall. Oh my god, what else would it be? God. I don't think it would be God. That seems a little bit far-fetched in several different and distinctual ways. Distinctuality is the kind of ality that you want. Oh, dang. Look where I am. Goodbye. Neat how you can open up the windows. Oh, I see the lack of a texture there. Oh, the lack of a texture in Thief is so much better looking than the lack of a texture in Doom. It's quite hilarious, in fact. Oh, man. So here I just go around in circles. Every which way. Did I read this or what? Weekly report of the front guard. As usual, nothing out of the ordinary to report. I'm starting to wish for some thief to show up. At least then we can finally get some action around here. Yeah. It's only when I'm not trying that I manage to do accents. Okay, seriously. Is this the armory? Could be.
Someone making noise.
Yeah. Alright, use what is over here being guarded by these dummies. Also possibly dum-dums, as I've... There's a very respectable term that is used in Kate Archer Goes to Blanchett Land. And it's like, not laugh-worthy at all. Bullets are dum-dums. It's really serious. You could get killed by a dum-dum. Don't laugh. Okay. To all guards, if I ever run into one of those harlots on the grounds again, be assured that the one responsible will be fired immediately. He can then try earning his money on the streets just alike, and enlist at the city watch if he prefers. What an insult. So... This is just like another circular thing. I'm not 100% sure exactly how one would normally... Oh, one would circle around the house, I guess, is what one would do. Fine.
Double fine is a thing you can pay when you've had twice as much fun as you're allowed.
Because as a privileged guy whose body always aches all the time and is miserable and will refuse to think of anything else, I... don't know anything about suffering of the masses who go through real actual suffering. I only know some inconvenience I could probably fix with yoga. Yeah, yoga for guards. That's what these guys are doing. It's a new form of yoga where you sing in unison as well, and you also just kind of sway around and spot. It's like a subtle form of yoga, where you kind of go like, yo, and then, gah! That was an attempt at a pun. Amazing, I know. I like that. I like these guys. They're quite... fun, and my type, I mean, they have funny voices, and they got loot, and just let me walk up and hit them. Uh-oh. Damn! You despairal! So I guess I could try to go over that side somehow instead, and, you know, thusly loot that guy. Probably the better idea. But, never you mind that. Is this the finest wine? I'm guessing the finest wine is going to be distinguished from the merely, you know, that's fine wine. It's just my favorite kind because it's non-alcoholic. So it's not really fine at all if you're into wine, but, you know... Really, what I'm saying is that's fine wine is grape juice, which is a pretty tasty kind of juice to me, which I always drink whenever others drink wine. I'm sure I look really cool doing it, but I don't know, man. Grape juice and club soda, it's an amazing feast. Amazing feast. Just the dogs. They're on leashes. It's just a wonderful, wonderful event. You know, I've never seen anything like it. You know, man, I should probably adjust my keyboard and mouse to be off this other board that's an actual board. Oh, it's a snossage. By which I mean a sausage. Pronounce it rightly, Finn. Because, you know, that's how you know it's a Christine mission, because there's food in it ever. Oh. Yeah, opening a door. It's an amazing wake-up call. I mean, I know why that happens in a technical sense, but I'm still going to make fun of it. God. Apparently, some thief keeps troubling the house, you know. At first, nobody noticed because only small amounts went missing. Over time, however, though, it's been, adding up to a pretty fair amount there. Since the theft spanned a period of several weeks, we have to assume that the thief either lives in the mansion or frequents the mansion virtually every day.
Unfortunately, for now his lordship suspects the staff, namely the servants and the guards. We must find this thief as soon as possible to remove ourselves from scrutiny. I know that some of you are anything but choir boys, but none of you have ever stolen anything, which I can say with confidence. I'm absolutely sure that none of you is the thief, you know. I suspect just one of the servants. My money's on David, because he often hangs around in the old Tokyo Inn, where the worst of the city's scum can be found. Keep an eye on him wherever he leaves the property, and make sure that one of you follows him. Maybe we can figure out where he hides his loot and convict him that way. Until then, you're to behave as if nothing was wrong around him. Do not let him sense that he's under suspicion, or else he'll make off with the douchebag loot and we'll stand empty-handed and with no evidence before his lordship, eh? Whoever catches the thief red-handed will be rewarded with 3 days special leave and 6 bottles of beer all at once. John Berger, captain of the guard. Not sure if I'm Canadian or, like, whatever that accent is from that Metalocalypse guy. You know, Pickles the drummer, who I haven't watched that show in a long time. It's a show, all right. It's got, jokes about extremely professional things. Also heavy metal, which is not at all professional, because, you know, when Alice Cooper walks into your car dealership to buy 5 cars, you don't want to turn him away because of his scraggledy clothing, man. You just can't tell who has money and who doesn't. I'm definitely making this up and not just quoting stuff I read on the internet about, like, car dealers truly are really, really innocent and don't screw people over. Let me tell you why, as a guy who's a car dealer. Oh, also, there's a ghost there. It's incredible. Also, this looks incredibly interesting, but isn't. Uh-oh. It's everything you could want. It's a ghost. I guess he's trying to guard the chest, but he couldn't do it, so that's why he's dead, you see? So finally, I moved into my new home. This is the place where I'm going to start a family and enjoy life to the fullest! That old fool, Lord Carden, has none but himself to blame for his fate. My first offer for this property was quite fair, generous even, but he just wasn't inclined to sell at all. Now he knows that I, Lord James Borlamus, always get what I desire. By no means was he willing to sell his property, and he had no financial problems either, so I had to help set things in motion. First, I sabotaged his metal foundry. There was a nice big fire, and Lord Carden lost his main source of income. He was planning to rebuild the factory, but I made use of my connections with the 2 directors of the local savings and loan bank and made it clear to them that Lord Carden was in no way creditworthy any longer. Fairly convenient how he can just do all that. Next, I approached Lord Carden again and offered to buy his property, but he remained stubborn as before. So I talked with his suppliers and customers, and it did not take long to discredit him. He was already falling behind on bills due to the loss of the factory. Yet, even my 3rd offer was rejected by this arrogant idiot, so I had to resort to harsher methods. It did cost me a pretty penny, but finally I persuaded his doctor to drug him up with potions that would cloud his mind. This guy is the most persuasive guy in town. Only a few weeks passed, and Lord Carden's increasingly abusive behavior in the public caused his mental sanity to be questioned. Another tiny sum to bribe the judge of the local court, and Lord Carden was officially declared as deranged and a danger to the public, and the judge had him committed to the asylum. To settle the outstanding debts by Lord Carden and to pay for the cost of the asylum, the judge put the property up on the register for public auction. I managed to snatch this property for a fraction of its actual value and had it renovated right away. That old Lord Carden had so many old books and other clutter accumulated in the library that I instructed my librarian to take all the worthless junk into the rearmost part of the basement. Lord Carden is now counting the days of his miserable existence in a mental hospital, and I made arrangements that he will not leave his new home alive. Lord James Borlamus, you know, this sounds more like a power fantasy than something that actually happened, but hey, whatever. Alright. The old chronicle. Alright, so the rearmost part of the basement? Or something? Yes, the rearmost part of the basement. And here's a ghost, so, like, maybe I can help this guy by, like, holy watering him to death. But wait. It's a ghost. So that means that there's Carden is dead and his ghost came back here, or is this just like a random? Is that Lord Borlamus himself? I don't know. I guess it's just like, hey, it's a spooky evil area. We got a ghost up in here. Ooh boy. My arms are like the arms of a Psychonauts character.
baby.
And oh my god, Raquel's playing Psychonauts, and it's so great to watch him stumble through it for the first time and like not know what keys do ever and stuff. And like, oh my, it's just great. But for serious, oh ho 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 ho. 964 out of 5,000. What is going on? There must be a treasure trove up in here, and I'm not talking about of food. Well, this was supposed to be, you know, like a, you know, mission 3 in a campaign. Or a campaign. A chaperone, if you want to make up a word. Why wouldn't you? All of my fans make up the best words. What do your fans do? I vote for the birthday cake. Apparently that is a thing I said, but more on that later. I'm afraid that I'm totally overworked. I really need to relax and find some relief urgently. For weeks, I've heard strange noises above me during the night. Footsteps, voices. Apparently the sounds originate from the attic. Strangely, I am the only person who seems to hear this noise. Last night, I heard the sound again when Peggy was still with me, and she claimed to not hear anything at all. Well, she's as dumb as a post anyway. She actually believes that I would love her. She's just a pretty maid and a nice diversion, but how can she possibly believe that someone like me, Lord Algernon Borlamus, would love a person like her? I think it is about time to instruct my administrator to dismiss some of the maids and hire a few fresh ones. Over the years, Marwyn has become familiar with my preferences, and a change would do me good for sure. This morning, I went up to the attic to see if I could find anything unusual. I had not been up there since my childhood, when my father had once caught me playing in the attic. The subsequent punishment had stopped me from ever setting a foot up there again. Oh, so that guy wasn't the current lord. It was like an older lord, so this house has been in the family longer than I thought. Fine. In recent years, I haven't even thought about the place. Today, there was nothing up there, of course, besides some old furniture and carpets. But in the last room, I found my father's old notes. I cannot tell you how glad I am to have found them. They are a treasure trove to me, since I can still learn a lot from my father. The story about how this property had come into our family's possession makes me proud. What? My father was truly a great businessman, and I am on a par with him. Within the next few days, I'll sort my father's notes and take them with me to my chamber. Well, I didn't expect him to react that way. I want my son Lucas to receive these notes as soon as he is old enough, and I really hope that Lucas will develop an equally good sense for business and perhaps some scruples for the blatantly obvious as his father and grandfather one day. Where did I put my pipe? It is not here. Perhaps in the library? I really need a vacation. Urgently. But only after having the wedding of Corinna and Count Meinhardt signed and sealed. This business relationship will incline my annual turnover by 12% at least, and increase my wealth considerably. I always thought that daughters would only cost money and bring nothing back in return. Perhaps I should visit my wife once more, just for a change. Another daughter could be married profitably in 13 years' time. Wow, if Melissa just wasn't so prudish, as soon as I... what? Yeah, whoa. Anyways, she cannot provide me anything. If she had not brought a good dowry into the marriage, she would never have become my wife, but she does not appreciate the great honor she's been allowed. Women, no sense of business at all, but always spending the money. that is a sexist statement, because it's funny, ain't it? Anyways, yes. As I was blatantly saying, with no regard to the mission. Yeah, where's this fine wine? Is it not here? Probably is a wine cellar. When I was just a kid, apparently, I had to go with my parents to the voting place because nobody was there to babysit me or something. And they were just like, we're voting. And I'm like, I vote for the birthday cake. Kid, I don't know. Apparently it happened, and apparently it was cute. I don't understand either of those assertions, though. But, hey, what do I know about voting? I mean, what do I not know about voting? Everything. I vote every 5 minutes. I change my mind a lot, but... Hey, you know, I feel that that is the best political ideal, is to change my mind a lot. Also, I feel that probably, like, people should more be thinking about, like, what actually works in the real world rather than just, like, obsessively clinging to a political ideal, because if it doesn't work, then you have to keep doing it because you're dumb and won't, like, be flexible at all. It's amazing. Wait, is this... Oh. I didn't... Oh, yes, that's right. And that's downstairs, but I think I've been absolutely everywhere downstairs with no exception.
Stop right there!
Damn, that's not good. So,
maybe I could get up to a balcony then. Is that what you're kind of trying to tell me there? Okay, this is the attic. This is downstairs. Maybe if I go downstairs, I'll be able to rope up or something. Do I go? Wait, I don't even have any rope arrows. That's... Also, Crom's... This is Crom's blade. Crom? Okay. Oh, where could be an outside place with a balcony? I don't think... Oh, hello there.
Hello?
How goes? Excellent. Yeah, I don't see anything, really. What a pity. Well, just leave doors open so that, okay, yes, this is the armory, and this is how I got around there. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. And these are the scary dummies as opposed to the other kind of dummies that are non-existent, because scary ones are the only ones that exist. If you get the joke. Ho, ho, ho. Okay, so maybe around this side then, perhaps, maybe, perhaps. But what have we here? What have we indeed? I thought this was the ghostly attic place, but I guess not. Where? Oh, this is the not at all ghostly attic place. God damn it, man. What? I don't know what my bearings even are. Oh, it must be those doors, so I guess no can do. Also, there's like two different, or it's those or something. I don't know. No, it's definitely those. Yeah, two different houses. What goes on, man? Maybe one. Oh, the entire library is entirely separate. Who would have thought that an entirety of something could be an enormous?
You've messed with the wrong man, thief.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, man. What's that?
Looks like I may be fighting some ghost. I mean, there is a ghost, but I don't know. I have a couple of possible undead fightsmanship equipments over here. Possibly. Yeah, what are you whining about? Oh, watch that. Oh, watch that. Next thing you know, your kids will be reading. And that is the gateway drug to intelligence, which is the gateway drug to knowing words, which is the gateway drug to knowing about the word cocaine, which is the gateway drug to becoming a police officer, and you don't want that.
Just believed him like a taffer. Probably never was true. No.
Yeah, this is some kind of a hell of an awesome library. Just like huge, multi-floored catamaran. Galoncting over the ocean, carrying passengers to and from Seattle and Wisconsin. I think Seattle and Wisconsin are connected by the Great Blue Ocean. That sounds like something extremely likely. Okay, let's get you into permanent darkness. Thank you. So, somebody around here has noticed me.
Attention, assistants! It's about time for the two of you to stop loitering around here and do something for a change. I will see to it that both of you finally get your hands on all of the books in this library at least once. It's a shame that you guys are too lazy to actually read them. Starting today, you will dust every last one of them. And be warned, I will be expecting them later, every single one, because I have time for that, and I will not accept even a single grain of dust on any of them. And in case you find anything out of the ordinary not belonging to a bookshelf, candies, scraps of paper, old keys, then you are to deliver such items to me immediately. Hello, good to work! Richard Forsyth, librarian of his lordship. Can I get some candies and old keys? Keys are the tapestry to my life. And boy, I sure have a lot of them.
Actually, I'm thinking of the mission called Key Hunt. Not the Sean Connery mission.
Mr. Forsyth, sorry about that.
On the 10th day of the month, I expect another delivery of precious books. Please send them to my study and see to it that they're handled with the greatest of care. I want to assure myself of the condition of the books before they're shelved in the library. Lord Algernon Bourlemur.
What is Bonhomme?
Good, excellent, excellent. This J-E-P-P-E-R-D-I show is going very well indeed. So, for some reason, cigars, yeah, ruin the books with smoke. For some reason, this guy's standing there, and I'm not sure, like, what I'm meant to do about him. It's just kind of, maybe he was supposed to be sleeping. Wait. I know there was a guy standing around somewhere. Oh, there he is. How odd. I don't know what his deal is. Also, I'm supposed to get the old chronicle, which I guess, I mean, it's probably in the basement because it was so specific about stuff being moved there. There's that CG teapot. Very good. I guess that guy's like, wait, there's nothing over here. Or, alternatively, also I think flash bombs, like, they make a noise on the floor. I know, amazing observation, and that might actually count as a real noise. I probably shouldn't be using all of these flash bombs on these guys, but I'm using my tools. I mean, gotta use some part of my tools, even if that part is fairly unmentionable. Okay, so I have to go all the way back here just to get upstairs. It's the Library of Encouragement of Exercise, paid for by the Foundation of Libraries for Encouragement of Exercise. Wow, sir, I didn't know you existed, sir.
Wonder what that noise
have
was.
Have a good day. Oh. Yeah, that's what I would say, too, if I were in your crazy position. Also, there's this door, too, like, for some reason, so maybe this is the basement? No. It's just a room who thinks that Ed is the one. But I did not sleep around just because I'm a rock star. You think I'd do that? Hell, what are you, crazy? And Mr. Forsyth, a few days ago I discovered a couple of old notes from my father in the attic. Besides other details, my father mentioned having given instructions to have a load of, in his opinion, worthless books moved into the rearmost part of the basement as he took over the estate. In his mind, it was nothing but shoddy plunder. Forsyth, you know as well as I do how little my father knew about the arts or literature. Imagine what hidden treasures might slumber down there. I request you to pay a visit to the cellar and see what you can find. The key to that old cellar was given by my father to Paul Wright, your predecessor as librarian. I'm pretty sure the key can still be found somewhere in the library. Find it and let me know as soon as you have the books brought up. Take David along. He can help with the hauling. Lord Algernon Borlemus. Find the key for the old cellar. It cannot have disappeared just like that. It must still be somewhere in the library. Easy for him to say. The library is huge. And, to put it straight, my predecessor, the old librarian Paul Wright, was a hopeless drunkard. Many things went missing under his sloppy tutelage, and the place became a giant mess. I shudder to think about what the librarian looked like before his lordship hired me to properly tutor the keys and books. The father of Lord Borlemus was never showed any interest in the library either. He simply lacked any appreciation for literature, which is why they keep a library. I guess it's to impress other nobles. Luckily, his son differs, at least in this respect, from his father. When his father died, he had the library renovated from scratch and hired me to bring order into this chaos. But this was more than 20 years ago, and by now the library of Lord Borlemus is one of the largest libraries in the entire country. And now I am supposed to find some old key for a cellar which has been forgotten for more than 30 years. Even if there had been some rare treasures among the books down there, I wonder what condition they might be in after so long. But most importantly, where the hell am I supposed to be able to find this damn key? Richard Forsyth, etc., etc., etc. Also, the library is large-ish, but seeing it's one of the largest in the land might be not seeming to be the case. Oh, right, this is only the second floor. Right, I thought there was three floors, in which case, well, I guess, I guess it is a pretty huge private library. In fact, I'm just misremembering scale. As tends to happen. Oh boy, one time when I was, 11 or something, my mom had this scale for, like, weighing food and stuff, like a smallish scale. And I, like an idiot, was, like, absentmindedly fiddling with this dial on it. And I accidentally untightened a screw and the whole mechanism fell inside and I was horrified. I opened the whole thing up to try to get the thing back out again, and I ended up breaking it even further. And, well, I don't know. That's my story. And then,
You know, my mom thought that I just opened it up out of curiosity, and for some reason, Oh, you're Richard Forsyth. Hey, how's it going? And for some reason, I've never just told people what I was doing because I've always been afraid to. It's weird. Anyways, it's nothing to do with anything. I'm sure that you're all extremely pleased to have heard that amusing anecdote. And, misconstrued everything. So he did say there might be old keys on the bookshelves. So maybe I'm supposed to look at the bookshelves for old keys. I don't know. I really wonder where the draft is coming from. The doors are constantly slamming shut for no reason. I've had enough of this. I will ask my architect to come by for a closer look. Uh-huh. So just go here. Secret eating bookshelf. But in what room? Well, probably not this one on account of the fact that, you know, there are no bookshelves in this room! Go on! I think I still have somebody to knock out over here. Yes, that's my amazing job, and it is amazing, make no mistake. Yeah, and there's Ida Lewis, who I totally knew about before Google told me what you're talking about. So, I mean, yeah, like, the library is huge, and I do, like, not know where a key is, like. So, I don't know what hint I'm supposed to take from that thing at all. Yeah, bring the hammer down. Oh man, Fen, get the notes right. Practice that singing. Okay, I'm gonna practice my singing. You ready? Okay, let's do some vocal exercises. Okay, time for another one. Okay, now I think that's enough of that one. Now let's try singing. Red and the black! Awesome, I'm really improving. Of course, Hollywood bad singing does not sound nearly as funny as real bad singing, sadly enough. One time I was practicing singing like Halford, and somebody outside my window told me to shut up, and that's why I think I'm a bad singer. It's great. I'm blaming others for stuff. It's amazing. Dude, okay, so there's a draft, so I guess there's a secret door, and also I guess there's maybe a key. I'm not sure. Perfectly honest. And that's also why I don't have it in me to, like, criticize people to their face, because I'm like, well, what if they are like me and have no skin at all, and that would be bloody. And yeah, but that's probably a dumb thing to think, because seriously, it's, you know, I'm just like, well, I wouldn't want to stop someone from doing what they love, but I guess that's not a thing. Seriously. I mean, like, there was a few people standing around. There was that one guy up there looking at a bookshelf. This guard wasn't looking at a bookshelf, but he was standing around. I don't know, man. Well, I mean, obviously I'm not stopping to want to sing, so, I mean, I don't mean that, but I mean, like, you know, I might take someone's confidence away. Don't ruin the flyer's confidence. Flying is like 70% one thing and 80% the other. Look, yeah, Rainbow Dash can be arrogant, but look, she's funny when she does it, so it's okay. So apparently, there's this thing over here. That's pretty well hidden. In fact, it's even that kind of key. Awesome. And a globe full of polygons, even better. And regular wine, pah. Oh, what a calamity! What a disaster! It's not enough that my master was sent to the mental hospital, but my new master, Lord James Borlamus, is a really obnoxious person. No sense of art or literature at all. He ordered us to send a considerable contingent of the precious antique books down into the rearmost part of the basement. In his opinion, just worthless plunder anyway.
That cellar. No, I must not remind myself of it. It was horrible. I have to write it down to get it off my chest. I can no longer bear to keep it in memory. Along with a couple of servants and my young assistant, Henry Potter, we carried the crates with the books down into the cellar. This rear part of the basement was never actually being used. It was dark and eerie, and all of a sudden we heard a terrifying noise, which I am unable to describe, which went through my very marrow and sent shivers down my spine. The servants felt it too. We all ran fast as lightning to get the hell out of the cellar. Fortunately, we made it to the metal door safely. I locked the door immediately so that whatever had caused the terrible noise could not possibly follow us. I was such a confused and nervous wreck that I got myself drunk into a stupor that very evening. As I woke up the following afternoon with a terrible hangover, I was perplexed because my assistant Henry had not shown up for work. I didn't know about it at first, but he did not appear the following day either. I inquired the servants and the guards about him, but no one had seen any trace of Henry since, well, since we had been to the basement. I dare not think about what might have happened to him down there. I tried to persuade the guards to escort me down into the cellar and have a lookout for Henry. Maybe he still might have been alive. But the guards were just as terrified as myself, and I couldn't possibly dare to go there single-handed. Poor Henry. He was pretty chaotic, but he was a really nice lad who might have had a bright future ahead. This damn cellar. I must make sure that nobody goes down there ever again. I'll keep the key here in my hiding place and hope it will never be discovered. Phoenix Wright Librarian.
Okay. Well, I don't remember seeing a door with this sort of lock on it, but I suppose if I just keep going, it will eventually reveal itself to me. And we can all just get going down to Black Country. Down to Black Country. That's Cockney, right? So there was a draft or something, but not in that room. How weird is that, y'all? Pretty weird. Well, good thing I découvrirde. That's French. This because, sérieusement, yeah, so I'm going to have to go into that Guardy McGardison room, which I would like to get into right about... right about now. End statement. Wow. Really being armed to the gills, the teeth, the chain, the hook, and the telephone wire up in here. Oh! Oh, shoot. If everyone's the same, oh, no one wins the game. Oh, this song hopefully is not too off-key. You're breaking the law. I think my problem is I'm trying to actually follow in real time what a song is doing by listening, whereas what I should actually be doing is learning the notes beforehand, so that I don't have to worry about listening hard to get the notes right. That's probably what I... Yeah, okay. But anyways, that's irrelevant. But everything I say it. Literally everything. That's a guard. Oh, I'm sorry. That was...
Is someone over?
Relevant. I apologize for saying something relevant. You two aren't going to have a funny talkmanship, are you?
Help! You can't hide for long!
God, you guys. Seriously. Just... I'm trying to interrupt your funny romantic moment, and this is how you repay me. Let's eat an apple in disgustment. That's not good wine either. What is good wine? I just don't know. God damn it, where's the regular house? It's over the other side. Why am I thinking it isn't? Except I don't want to get to it from that side. What? Oh, man. No glute on you.
No glutes either, probably.
I don't even remember what that is, but it's probably something in the leg or the skull. Pretty sure it's the skull, yeah. Yeah, this place is fancy. Look at this big stuff, big everywhere, big. Whoa, what is going on here? Bumping into people, that is the theme of this party. Well, gives a new meaning to rubbing shoulders. Oh, no, it's the same meaning, Fen. Come on. Looking for some upstairs-y type stairs. Oh, I think I might be close.
Close. Close.
Here we are. Right, so. As I left off in some bloody room or another. Oh, what? What are you doing? What the actual shit are you doing? Actual heck are you doing? Wait, that other guy walks too? Or am I hearing wrong? Or are you the guy? probably make more sense.
Nobody better be taffing around down here.
Nobody's taffing around down here, mate. Just peeking through the curtains. Not taffing at all. Okay. Well, now that I'm rubbing shoulders with this guy, I'll leave it here, so see you guys next time, and bye for now.